And that's a song you can take with you during the week, that's for sure. Beginning a series, I just felt the Lord really... So what does it mean? What does it matter that you are a follower of Jesus Christ? How do you handle your life? How do you live different from other people? There's a key teaching in the Bible. It's called the Sermon on the Mount. And the Beatitudes tell us exactly how Jesus wants us to live. A totally new way to live. And I want to tell you, I thought I knew, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Preached on this in 1995, did a series. I thought I knew pretty much what this meant. I learned so much this week. As I got down on my knees and I asked God, what does this mean? And it's my high privilege, and I'm still on my knees, as I hope to share this with you this morning. Matthew chapter 5, verses 1 through 3. And the focus verse is verse 3. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Lord, speak this word to us. May it change our lives. And help us to feed from your table today. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Now, I said this at 8 o'clock this morning, and I've used this illustration before. I just feel like this is vanilla ice cream. And you know, sometimes, you know, in a sermon or message, you want it to be a Sunday. You want this, you want that, you want the other thing, cute stories and everything like that. But this is just, and you know, sometimes I like getting just a big glob of vanilla ice cream, sometimes, as long as it's good. Amen? Amen. So that's my hope. And this message is in three parts today. Blessed. What does blessed mean? Second part, poor in spirit. What does that mean? And third thing, kingdom of heaven. What are we talking about? Okay, blessed, happy, and inner satisfaction and sufficiency. You're not like this in order to be saved. You can live like this because you are saved. Our true appetite is best expressed by Augustine, this prayer. You have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they find their rest in you. Didn't know this? There are two words in the Bible for blessing. Makarios and eulogetos. Eulogetos, E-U, good. Logos, word, equals good word. It's when you speak well about somebody. Can you think of an application for eulogetos? A, eulogy. It's when you speak a good word about somebody. Then the other word for blessed is makarios. Makarios is more than eulogetos. It defines a condition that exists. It's something absolutely true, not just said. Makarios, the biblical word for blessed, is a reality, an inward state of truth, no matter how you actually feel. It defines an inward state of being in relation to God. It's a thus saith the Lord situation in you. It's in you more than it's out there. You are blessed even when you don't feel blessed. God, how can I illustrate this? And this is what God gave me. There's a 2-year-old child. They have a glass of milk, and they spill it all over themselves, and they start crying up a storm. That child But that child is blessed. You know why? Because you're the parent or grandparent, you're going to clean that child up, you're going to clean up the spill, and in your refrigerator you have 10 more glasses of milk. That child is not happy, but that child is blessed. Amen?
Amen.
Same in our lives. We face tough situations sometimes, and God is declaring us blessed. Makarios is divine favor. The kind of happiness that comes from receiving God's blessing. And inner contentedness that is not affected by circumstances. We're going to look at this more adult Sunday school today. Makarios is found 49 times in the New American Standard Bible translation. So in your Bibles, it's about 50 times you'll see Makarios, translated blessed. Here are some examples of blessed. Psalm 1:1. How blessed is the one who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers. That's a scoffer. Psalm 32:1. How blessed is the one whose sin is forgiven, whose sin is covered. 32:2. How blessed is the one whom the Lord does not impute iniquity, and whose spirit there is no deceit. Makarios is a favor and a blessing that God gives. Blessed are the poor in spirit. By the way, I copied down the other night, the commentary, like, dared you to do it. Said, I'm still new on the computer. It had all these blue texts, so I quick got out my Bible, and all I had to do was put my pointer on the blue text, and it would amplify it on my computer. And there were about 20 verses describing blessed in the Psalms. The Makarios, the blessedness that God gives His people. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Now stay with me. I'll learn more about poor in spirit too. Qualities. And Luke, it just says poor. Matthew, it says poor in spirit. And again, another commentary says, when it gets specific, God is talking about an inner relationship more than an outward condition. Qualities of poor in spirit: teachable, humble, willing to trust God completely, receptive. Opposite quality is pride. I'm good. Blessed are those who say, God, I need you. Blessed are those who say, God, I desperately need you. I can't live without you. It changes our life radically. A definition that I like of poor is this: poor people don't have what they need. And this beatitude is saying, blessed are they who know that they don't have all the answers. Blessed are they who know they don't have all they need. That they don't have it all together. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who know that God butters their bread. It's not my text. You know, one time, Bill Daly, professor of freshman year, told us a story. He was in this class, in this class, there were about four or five people there, and this professor was talking. Bill Daly had no, he's a professor at Stockton State College, Richard Stockton University now. He had no idea what this professor was saying. But then these two other hotshot students, they had patches on their jackets, you know, patches on the elbows, and everything that professor said, they go, yeah. They're getting this, and I'm not. It freaked them out. There's no other way to put it. He left the class, and as those two patch guys walked out of the class, the one said to the other, you have any idea what that professor was saying? And the other guy with the patch said, no, I had no idea whatsoever. I had no idea what that guy was saying. Bill Daly said that made him feel good. Blessed are those who have the guts to say, hey, wait a minute, I need I'd raise both hands, but I'd fall. Amen. One at a time. We can be poor in so many ways, physically, emotionally, spiritually, relationally, financially, occupationally. Some people hate their jobs, hate what they do. Help us, Jesus. I had a barber one time cut my hair and said, I went to a guy who was going to do a brake job on my car. I said, hey, you like your job? He said, I can't stand my job. Barber said, you ain't working on my car, and he drove away. I need help. I can't do it alone. God, I need your help. Here's the real meat. If you don't listen to anything, listen to this. Two words for poor in the Bible. P-E-N-E-S. Penis. Describes a person who works for a living. The reverse of someone who lives in affluence. It's a working person. But this is not the word used for poor in this verse. Pitoches, P-T-O-C-H-O-S, is used which describes absolute and abject poverty. Pitoches describes the person who has nothing at all. Utter destitution. The root word means to cower and to cover. Because you don't have anything and you're dependent upon someone else for your sustenance. This cannot be overstated. Totally dependent on help. A continual mindset which leads to a lifestyle of submission and continual dependence on God. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Makarios. Blessed are the people who know that they need God. And they live that way. God, I got nowhere else to go but you. And I need your help. Help me, Jesus. You gotta help me with this. I'm at the end of my rope. I need you. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. A piece of a quote from Billy Graham, our longings and dreams will be fulfilled. For theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The word is basileia. Where the king is, there is the kingdom. And the king is Jesus. Where Jesus is, there is the kingdom. And the kingdom of God is already and not yet. It's already here, and there's still so much not yet ahead. We will pray right before we receive communion. On earth as it is in heaven. Entrance into the kingdom is by new birth. Matthew 18:3. Unless you're converted and become like children, you will not enter. Unless you are converted and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. John 3:3. No one can see the kingdom of God unless they are born again. Or a little twist on that translation. In the Greek, born from above. Born from above. I can't live without your connection, Lord. I can't live without your word. I can't live without following you. Kingdom of heaven. Abundance. Happiness, harmony, success, adventure. I don't have what I need. God has what I need. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Amen. Let's pray. Lord Jesus Christ, Thank you for your word. You say, blessed are those who know, that they need you more than anything else. Help us to live in such a way. It's in your name we pray. Amen.